Did you know that when it snows, my eyes become large and the light that you shine can't be seen? There, I can feel you to a kiss from a rose on the grave. Ooh, the more I get, I feel stranger.
CoopKings.com. This is Rebel Link, and this is Batman Arkham Asylum, video 3. Okay, so we just defeated, Josh. However, we're gonna see him again later. And really, that was just your first tutorial on how to use the gargoyles, that are above the rooms. You know, how to go from one gargoyle to another, basically. That right there is a weak, if you look at it in detective mode, you'll see it as a weak wall, and you're gonna see a common theme in this game, and one of those things where the game makers want you to replay the game, so, kinda like, trying to think of a game that comes to mind, but I can't think of one, but, anyways, you're gonna see a lot of places you can't enter just yet, because you don't have the tools to enter them. So, once you beat the game, you can play it all over again, and have all your, you know, tools with you. So it's gonna make it a lot easier to find all those secrets that you weren't able to find before. As you kind of noticed before, those little green question marks, those are the Joker's, not the Joker, but the Riddler's, kind of like his mini secrets. So there's 240. Of them in this game. In this walkthrough, I'm not going to find all of them because that would just take way too long. But anyone that I run into, I'll be sure to obviously go get it and show you where it's at. But, you know, getting all 240 of those and really doing a lot of things in this game, because there's a ton of stuff that you can go look for and go get. Also, there's this, if you may have seen it on the internet already, but there's this thing called challenge mode, where basically, it puts you in this situation where, like, you know, you'd be in a room with a bunch of thugs and you have to take them all out silently, and it's timed, and for each difficulty there's a trophy. So, it's really neat, and then, once you beat it, it posts your score and, you know, puts it against versus everybody else in the internet world. So this is pretty funny. I jump off this and try and glide and I just fall down. What you're supposed to do is just, when you jump off, just hold on to A and you'll start doing this gliding thing. So basically we just saved one of the insane dudes. Quick note about the running and jumping. Because it just introduced that element just a few seconds ago. You don't have to push A to jump when it's time to jump. All you have to do is run towards a ledge, and if you're supposed to jump, the game will jump for you. So it's kind of cool that they just left it in the hands of the game, and you know, not have to worry about another series of button things you have to push all over again. So jumping. Same thing with climb. Sometimes that gets a little confusing in certain sections, certain levels and whatnot, but you know, it's all good. Okay, so I wanted to show you this real quick. You cannot open that with the batarang like I just tried to, but you're later going to get this device that will kind of blow those things up and open all those doors for you. So again, just like I said, you're not going to have all the tools just yet, but if you want to replay the game, which I highly recommend you do, especially when you get all the tools, those things are going to be available for you at the time. In fact, I saw a walkthrough today, not to rag on them or anything, but they're playing with all the tools, and they didn't, you know, they did put that in the description, but, you know, if you're looking for a walkthrough, I don't know if that's helpful. If somebody has everything you need and you're like, what the fuck, I don't have those things. So, this is my opinion. So again, like I mentioned, if you have an opportunity to do that takedown type thing, well, this is funny. Look how he ends up all mangled up. Okay, cool. The upgrade system. I'm only going to show you this one time because, you know, just in case you're curious on what it looks like. You have all these options on what to choose, and what I do is the first thing I choose is an inverted takedown. Because when you're in the room with enemies, that's one of the ways that's one of the things you could do to take out enemy and distract all the other characters, whatever. Because anytime you do that to somebody, they come running and, you know, save them, whatever. Alright, so there's a cutscene there, and it leads up to the first mini-boss. It doesn't have a name, but everybody's kind of been calling them the Venom Hentchman or something like that. So, everything I'm doing, in fact, I was supposed to do a double jump here. Yeah, I did a horrible job of playing this part. But that's what you're supposed to do. When he's about to run at you, throw those the batarangs at him. And, really, you just leave him alone. This is setting up a precursor to your first boss battle with Bane. Because he does everything that Bane does. And, but all you gotta do is that thing twice to him, and then he grabs his head, and I guess whatever the Joker injected with him, well, here it is right here. It's not sitting well with him. So it kills him. So it wasn't really a boss battle, but whatever. See you guys in the next video.